Hello there. In this video, I'm going to walk you through using associated objects with lists. This is a contact list. I'm going to click add filter. By default, it's using current object, which is contact. Click that. I'm actually going to choose deals. You can use tickets, any other these associated objects, deals, deal properties. I'm going to choose stage because what I want to do is create a list of contacts that have a deal that is currently open. I have a bunch of different pipelines. I'm just going to use a 2024 pipeline just to show you this working. And I'm going to choose any of these open deal stages. Okay. None of the closed ones. There we go. And I'll click save. It's going to build that list. And there you go. 32 contacts have an open deal associated with them. So you might say, firstly, well, why didn't I just use lifecycle stage? Well, it's quite possible you have a closed deal already with a contact, and therefore they might actually be a customer. So using deal stages is useful. And also you might only want stages from a particular pipeline like I did in this case. So there you go, 32 contacts. I might use this list in a view. I might use it in the marketing email. I might use it in a sequence, might use it in a workflow. As my HubShots co-host Ian always says, lists are the building blocks of HubSpot. Hope that's useful. Let me know.